So who would like to start?
Is Azra here?
Okay, where are you? Okay.
A request. Check. Hi, sir. Okay,
can you call me Rahul instead of sir?
Okay.
Makes me more comfortable.
Research institutions, the Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, faced a huge financial crisis, and henceforth the employees and the students of the institution were deprived of their salary for the month of February. As of now, the situation has been sorted. I think the salary has been credited to the respective accounts. But in the long run, what does your government think of this issue? Do you plan on doing anything about this? What do you think is the future of education?
About research and education in general, or about Tata Institute in specific?
About research and education in India.
I think we are convinced that India is spending way too little money on education. And we feel that India needs to spend much more money on education. So we are going to increase the amount of money that we spend on education, and our target is 6%. That's basically what we're looking at. It's not only about spending money in education. It's about independence of education institutions. So I come here and I can tell by listening to you for 5 minutes that you are an independent institution, that you have the right to say and do whatever you like, and that there is an atmosphere in this institution of openness, of listening. I think another thing that we have to focus on is the imposition and the capture of India's institutions. I believe that all our institutions should be free to challenge ideas. I don't think you should blindly accept any idea. I think you should be able to challenge ideas, and that's why, frankly, I've come here. Because I want you to challenge me. I want you to make me uncomfortable so that I learn, I understand what you think and I learn from you. So it is a mutual learning, and that should be the design of the education system. But broadly, much more money in education, and I don't believe that the solution to India's education problems is blatant privatization. So I believe, yes, there is a place for private institutions, but solid government-funded government institutions also have their place, and they should be the standard bearers. So people should look. I mean, if you look at the IIT, the best technical institution in the country, it's a government institution. So the government has a responsibility to set the benchmark, and then everybody else can follow that. That would be broadly my answer. Thank you.